Looks like you're requesting some kilobyte usage that was done while in Canada. $0.002.
Do you recognize that there's actually...
0.002 cents.
Yes. Do you recognize there's a difference between those two numbers?
No. $0.002 and $0.002 cents.
Yes. Is there a difference between...
They're both the same if you look at them on paper-wise.
No, they're not, actually.
So if you take .002...
Cents, remember. It's cents.
Times 35,800... $71.79.
No, that would be 71 cents. How much should I be charged?
By for the way this is calculated, $71.79. You're paying 0.2 of a penny per kilobyte.
Two tenths of a penny would be 0.2 cents. You quoted me 0.002 cents. So which is the real rate?
0.002, sir.
0.002 what?
Cents per kilobyte.
So you just said it was 0.2 pennies. And then you also said it's 0.002 cents. Those are two completely different numbers. They're 100-fold different.
Okay, George, hold on 1 second for
sure.
Me, okay?
Andrea, I'm a manager on the floor. How can I help you
today? Hi. Do you recognize that there's a difference between $1 and 1 cent?
Definitely.
Do you recognize there's a difference between half a dollar and half a cent?
Definitely.
Yep. Then do you therefore recognize there's a difference between $0.002 and
$0.002
cents?
No.
I'm teaching math here.
Hold on, let's try this one more time.
Do you recognize that there's a difference between $1 and 1 cent?
Definitely.
Do you recognize there's a difference between half a dollar and half a cent?
Of destiny.
Definitely.
Then do you therefore recognize there's a difference between $0.002 and $0.002 cents?
No.
I'm teaching math here.
We're going to have Destiny or Stephen Bonnell join us for this cast of SPS versus GMMA, and we are going to wait on the third gamer here for right now. Waiting on Maven to create the game or something.
Hey, Thunder Bro, what's up?
Not much. Waiting for this third game to get created so we can get in there.
You should link me to the stream.
To my stream?
Yeah, the one that's going on now so I can post it.
There's my stream.
Got it. How do you clear chat again? Oh, there you go.
Bang,
sorry.
Clear.
Yeah, I got it. All right. That's what we're looking for.
I think we have SPS up 2-0 right now with SPS Cookies taking this in a PvT and a PvP, beating Acer and NYD, who are both very good players, and I know they were at least top 200 at some point in time. I'm not sure what their current ranking is though.
So what are we waiting on? Are they, like, idling, or?
There we go. The game's just created. Not sure what they were taking so long for, but... Can you join off me? You can, right? Thought it would bring us both into it, but...
I can't join game. It's blacked out.
Try now.
Hold on, I gotta find your name. Oh, cool.
Nice, I like how you're playing.
Who, what?
I like how you were in the player spot.
Oh.
Looks like it's gonna be SPS Cookies versus Tunk of GMMA, a PVZ this time. Again on Lost Temple, though.
This is their third game?
Yep, this is game three with SPS up 2-0.
Alright, so is it the first time these two have played, or is this the third game between
Cookies
just...
Cookies has been the player in the first two games, so it looks like they're going for a winner's format here.
Got it.
So we have Tunk, GMMA, the green Zerg spawning in the 9 o'clock position here. Cross position, we have SPS Cookies, the pink Protoss, on his third game here. Oh, got a pause coming in.
That's pretty bad.
So again, the pink Protoss in the 3 o'clock position, cross positional PVZ on Lost Temple. How do you feel about PVZ on Lost Temple?
How do I feel about PVZ on Lost Temple? I don't know. I think it's it gets a lot easier to defend against some all-ins on this map because of the nature of being able to spine your base up on your expansion and being able to defend your main at the same time. In the same token, it's a lot harder to harass the Protoss if he goes for an early fast expansion.
Yep, it looks like that's what he's gearing to do. We do see that pylon going down at the front of his base, at the bottom of his ramp. Well, it looks like there is space in between, so we're not going to sure what he's going to do with that. Probably going to be some kind of fast expand. Forge fast expands kind of went out of style with the Roach buff a while ago, but we have seen some players going back to them now. It is going to be a Forge Fast Expand from Cookies. Interesting to see what Tunk will do. He is getting that pool up and gas up, so we're going to be able to open up for some speedlings. See if he transitions to Roaches or just decides to grab that natural and get some mutas out to harass.
Oh wow, this Zerg might be in trouble. If it looks like he's throwing up six lings, unless his Protoss doesn't get any cannons up in time. But if the Zerg fails his push here, he's gonna be super behind.
Yep, we do have eight lings coming out. The first six now just hatching, making their way across the map. Looks like a probe. Yep, is gonna scout this.
Yeah, all the Protoss has to do at this point is pull probes.
We do have that one cannon about 4/5 of the way done already, and it looks like Tunk doesn't even know where his opponent is right now.
Oh boy.
So this is not looking good for him. Just now starting that link speed, still building lings. Second cannon going down for Cookies.
Yeah,
it
I can't.
Gap to this.
I can't see this attack doing much damage. the Ling, the Zerg's pretty much committed at this point. He's got more Lings coming into his main.
Yep, already lost one Ling to that first cannon. Second cannon about 3/4 of the way done. Not looking good. And I'm not sure why he's going so, like, Ling all in this map. You actually see him morphing a lair already, so might be deciding to go,
I can't see what he could possibly do. He's got so few drones. I don't know.
Seer? I'm thinking, like, Nidus and Baneling Nest is the only thing he could do. Or maybe just a Nidus really quick. Has anything. Opening up Forge first means you really don't have anything for quite some time. See, it doesn't even have a Zealot yet. Now getting a Cybernetic Score. Getting his first Zealot out, finally. Cybernetic Score, moving it over. Pretty strange.
Even more so Lings coming in from the Zerg.
Yep, this lair is almost finished. He's also grabbing his second gas, running off of very few drones. He's only got 9 harvesters right now, and only 6 of them on minerals. So this is a very, very all-in. But he does have all his Lings at his main, which makes me think that he's going to go for that Nidus play. Now trying to put 3 more drones.
He literally has twice as many drones on gas as mineral field.
As minerals.
I don't think I've ever seen that before.
Yeah, I'm thinking this is going to be a Nidus all-in. We do have an Overlord at the top. Moving around to get some vision on the back of that base, it looks like. We will be able to avoid all the cannons, but I think, I mean, since that natural nexus is already up, he should be just fine. But yes, we do have that Nidus being started. It's about halfway done right now.
I see. You see the Overlord coming in from the top to scout for where the Nidus is going down.
Yep. Protoss does not have any vision there. If you do a forge first like this, as a Protoss, you want to make sure you either have some Zealots patrolling there or some pylons on the outer rim of your base, especially if you don't have good scouting information.
I'm a little confused as to the Protoss. He knows that the Zerg is on one base, so he has to figure the Zerg is going to do something strange, but the Protoss hasn't really prepared for Mutalisks or really anything.
Has not prepared for anything. Does not have pylons behind his mirror line.
Not even.
Stuff to stop a Baneling Bust, which would be the other option. Well, there goes
this Nidus might actually. I don't even think those Lings had speed. But this Nidus might actually do quite a bit of damage.
Canceled
there's
it.
One.
Oh no.
One pylon powering all those gateways too, or the 2 gateways in the Robo facility.
And here come the Zerglings. Gonna go into the main. Still has a bunch in the Nidus though. Needs to outload them.
Oh man, those Lings need to go for the pylon.
Managed to take down the pylon, the robotic facility, and 2 gateways will remain unpowered. Going after the Nexus now. But again, I think he can just fall back to his natural and be just still ahead by a lot. Trying to have 2 more pylons, trying to get those gateways back powered. Trying to defend with 2 Stalkers and a Zealot.
I think this Nexus is going down.
Yep, Nexus is gonna go down. Gonna pick off a build, pick off a few of these gas probes. I think.
Zerg is still sitting on 8 drones. It'd be nice if he'd grab that speed upgrade. He's got the money for it.
He had it started, but I think he canceled it, realizing that he wanted the gas for this night. It's 3 more Zealots being worked in, and this looks like pretty GG. The Zealots gonna be able to take out these Zerglings. And I think a big mistake was that he still has like 16 Zerglings in the Nidus. Now outloading them, realizing that he still has far to go. That was a big mistake there. He's still in a decent position, using those warp gates, warping in a bunch of Stalkers. I think he would much prefer to have Zealot, especially since he has that Robo anyway, and an Immortal out. Probably just gonna go take care of this Nidus, but you see that main Nexus going back down again. Tunk Sank, just the manager of GMMA. Okay, I do not know who Tunk is, but apparently not very comfortable playing this game.
I guess it'd be like watching Rocky's trainer try to box. I don't know.
Yeah.
Can't see the Zerg holding off much at this point, though. Still sitting on 8 drones.
Yeah, not looking good for him. Just has a bunch of lings out. Should probably work on his GG timing.
GG timing might actually be the most important part of this build, of the 8 drone, no speed, night is fresh.
Yep, you have stalkers putting on pressure on these no speed lings. Followed up with an immortal, a sentry, and a couple zealots. Placing a proxy pylon in his opponent's base, gonna be able to warp in up on the high ground. That robotics bay, about halfway done now.
Hey, we got speed.
Speed finally finishing, actually getting a decent surround on this. But more stalkers in that pylon is about to finish. Gonna be with a bunch more zealots. Gonna not even there. Stalkers almost go down, but stalkers are more.
That stalker did go down, that was good.
There's
not quite enough though.
Replay save.
going for that kind of a ling bust on even if you were to do it better, execute it better with the with speed and everything, going for a ling bust on that map is really risky because all the Protoss has to do is wall off and your entire attack is negated. Then you have to try to salvage it with the baneling bust, which and it takes so many banelings to kill a Protoss building because they have so much HP. I don't know, I don't think that's a good counter to a Forge Fast Expand.
Yeah, I think he was just really nervous. He said that he was the worst player on GMMA and that he's just the manager. But I mean, that is one of the worst maps to do it on. You saw that in the beginning, he didn't even know where his opponent was. So he was significantly delayed. Lost Temple is really good for those fast expansions, even in SE1. Has that nice high ground overlooking that small choke point to your natural. So like you said, even if it fails and you try to do a Bandling Bust, it's fairly easy to hold off as well. Tried to go for that Nidus play, but just not doing enough. And there's just no way I think that cross positional. I think you'd be much better off playing a macro game, getting that second, third hatchery, instead of trying to go for an all in.
I missed. I actually missed the timing on that pool though. That pool seemed extremely early. I want to say 10 or 11.
Yeah, I think it was a 10.
Yeah. I almost thought that the Protoss was going to pylon in the Zerg on that map because he rushed that Forge out, but then I saw that the Zerg pool was almost done. Also, if you're going to try for a Ling Buster, that it's probably important that you scout the enemy first. It's kind of...
kind of important, yeah.
A little bit.
So that was Cookies taking three games off of Clan GMMA. I'm not sure they're going to send up next. Better send up some kind of ace here. But
Ace Gamer.
Not really
Destiny,
sure who
what?
Else is on GMMA besides NYD and Acer.
What about Acer Gamer? Isn't he on GMMA?
Yeah, he played first though.
He lost?
He did, and actually didn't play all that well. I was not actually impressed.
Well, that sucks.
So waiting on that map to be created. Again, I guess without chat and stuff, it's kind of hard to set up these large clan events and decide what map is on what and who's going up next. And you're trying to talk to your entire clan on a bunch of different windows.
You're about to get me started on this.
It's alright, hopefully, next patch they're supposed to put some stuff in.
If only there was some system in place where you could click the person's name and it would bring up a box. And then you could type, like, text, and the text would be delivered to the other person and it would show up in a box on their screen.
That's way too futuristic here. We're only dealing with Battle.net 2.0. I think you need to calm down.
Well, I was just talking about PMs. I don't know about chats. Did you go on the PTR at all and look at chat boxes or whatever?
I didn't actually. My PTR was one of the ones that was like broken and it wouldn't let me log in. So I just didn't bother. Plus, since I mostly just cast rather than play, it didn't make much sense to try to get it working anyhow.
Did you chat a lot in StarCraft Brood War?
Yeah, not a lot, but...
Were you ever in, like, Clan X17 or anything like that?
No.
Oh, man. Dude, you missed the best part of being on Battle.net.
Yeah, the old school.
The crazy chat channels. There was a lot of fun in there.
I'm seeing from my chat that this is the last game.
Uh-oh.
Which makes sense. I think this is the fourth game. See, SPS Maven bragging that SPS is better than GMMA.
Oh, boy.
I know SPS is, like, relatively new, and I know Maven was actually one of the ones who started helping us get the top 200 King of the Hill up and running by getting us in touch with some really good players. But I'm really not sure how good they actually are. But I know that they're playing in some tournament or clan tournament, and they're going to be facing VVV first. So they're going to work cut out for them. Looks like we do have the game created, so you can go ahead and join off of me. I think it'll be Cookies up again, going for the all kill, gonna 4-0 GMMA maybe. And wondering who GMMA is gonna send out. But currently in the team slots, we do have SPS Predator versus Amandil. I don't know who that is, of GMMA, but he is currently not in here, just pending still. Okay, we do have Cookies about to play, and I don't know if he's still going to be playing Amandil or whatever. So our last player of GMMA disconnected right now. I'm sure that he's going to get the re-invite, though. Again, I've never heard of this player, and I don't know if he's on the top 200 either. But he's going to have to try for an all-kill if he wants to bring GMMA to a victory here. Reverse all-kill. This is going to be pretty much match point for Cookies here. So PVZ on Metalopolis.
I believe in Amandil. What is that? What portrait is that?
I don't even know. I think it's one of the custom ones.
I can't tell. Normally I'm looking at Zerg units from the top down, so I don't know what their faces look like. I think there's a Your Mom joke in there somewhere, but I'm not going to make it. All right, Metalopolis.
So PVZ on Metalopolis, we have Amandil, the green Zerg, spawning in the 12 o'clock position. In his close air position, we do have SPS Cookies, winning 3 matches in a row already, going for his 4th here. And there's someone at my door, so I'm going to let you take over for now.
Oh boy.
While I go check the door.
They're actually really nice positions for ZVP for the Zerg. Zerg can hover overlords around this edge and keep the Protoss scouted for anything weird if the Protoss decides to turtle and tech up. We'll see if he pulls his overlord away so that the Protoss doesn't know that the Zerg's up there. Oh, and the Protoss actually sends a probe out. It's an old Brood War trick. Well, I guess, I don't know. Looks like he's going for another Forge Expand.
I would think so, though. That's a little bit harder on this map. The area behind the natural and the mineral line is fairly large.
Yeah, you leave yourself...
Lost Temple.
Yeah, you're open to some... Unless you make the Protoss is gonna have to make quite a bit of sentries, or really build this wall out with a cannon gateway cyber core.
Yep, you need a lot of cannons and a good number of sentries to hold this. It is very vulnerable to a roach all-in, or of course, like we were saying before, that Zerg can try to get the quick third up. That gold base is an option. Got that forge gate going down already. Pool for Amandil just about to finish, getting that gas up about one third of the way down right now. And immediately going Roach Warren, so it looks like he is going to try to put some Roach pressure on this. Not a bad idea, can really make the Protoss overinvest in cannons here, even if you don't finish them off. So what are your thoughts about Roach All-Ins? What do you usually respond to this kind of cannon expand?
Well, I mean, you really have two choices. You can either try and out-greed the Protoss. I mean, since you see him expanding, you know he's playing a little bit greedy. You can either try and take a second and super saturate it, or even take a third before the before anybody starts fighting. Or you can try for a one base All-In, which is kind of what it looks like this Zerg is elected to do.
We've got two cannons down already from Cookies. Well, again, he leaves that one space opening by that pylon at his ramp, which is very, very unusual. I'm not sure why he's doing that, but...
I'm not sure. I want to say he's just doing it for ease of units to move through. I saw him do it when he canceled his Cybercore that last game, although normally they would just wall and either break it later or warp units out of their base via warp gates. This is really strange. It looks like the Zerg is... Actually, this could work out really well for the Zerg. When the Protoss scouts this first rush, or this first roach, I mean, the Protoss has already invested three cannons worth of minerals for static defense, but it looks like the Zerg's just opted to macro. This Protoss Nexus is going down pretty late.
The Zerg actually gonna like beat this roach, I think. Not microing well enough.
Yeah, this is. I like this. If the Zerg did this intentionally, it was pretty smart. I mean, the Protoss opened with a fast expand build, but the Zerg is actually ahead in his expo, just because he kind of faked him out with that Roach Horn. Protoss has a lot of dead money sitting here in these cannons.
Yep, we got a probe headed across the map. We're actually going to scout this fast expansion. Well, not fast expansion, but Hatchery finishing up for our Zerg player, Amandil. Queen going to take out this probe pretty soon. Probe goes down. He does have a lot of larvae saved up, though. Six larvae for the Zerg here. And enough money to do something interesting. Might just drive it, though.
I think he might have just gotten supply capped. I see him waiting on two overlords right here.
We have probes transferring from Cookies right now. He is getting his warp gate research. The backer of the mineral line, though, is still very vulnerable. I wouldn't mind if we saw three or four more roaches come out from Amandil and put some pressure on back there. Again, that fast expand with Forge first from Protoss makes it quite a long time before they get any decent number of units out.
Yeah, that's true. The scary thing about pressuring early with roaches, though, against Protoss is that whatever roaches he sends out into the field are kind of stranded. Because stalkers move faster than roaches, if he sends out an inadequate number of them, the stalkers are just going to hunt down and kill the roaches, and the roaches will do little to no damage in exchange. That's one thing that keeps Zerg from harassing with roaches early game sometimes. You never want to send just two or three because you're scared that stalkers will just pick them off.
I mean, I would agree with you, but I think on the Forge Fast Expand, when you do it early enough, I mean, because we can see that only has got like one gateway down right now. He's a couple more coming up, so it depends on what your timing is, because usually if they don't know what you're doing, you can actually go for Lings or Roaches, and I mean, if they go Stalkers and if you go Lings, they're going to be SOL, man.
Yeah, that's true. I think, but just seeing the Zerg go for the fast expansion and everything, it didn't look like he was doing something to apply early pressure.
Yeah,
if you come in a Protoss, and he's not ready at all for any kind of Roaches, he just three or four Roaches can start picking off buildings like Cyber Cores or Gateways, and that can really set the Protoss back.
Right. If you just sack them, even if you were to sack three Roaches, I mean, as long as you keep them attacking the probes, that Stalker has to engage, so... Looks like the sentry, and that's huge. That sentry was the first unit out of the gateway, and so it was stockpiling energy, needed those force fields later. Wants to build a force field in case the Ling Roach pressure comes in the mid game. Looks like he's actually taking up straight to Golossov. You see that Robo Bay coming down already. Getting Observer out, and his fourth and fifth gateways now. So looking to hit a timing push. Also getting that plus one events, which is about 80% done.
I see the Zerg. It looks like the Zerg is going for a drop play. This could be kind of interesting with so many cannons at the front of his base.
Yeah, he's also getting Baneling, so he could see a Baneling drop on the mineral line, which is always exciting. We rarely see that. But again, the Protoss is going to be very front-loaded in his defense in this map, just because it is such a large area to defend at that natural. So if you look at the main, we see almost nothing there. We have one pylon powering all the tech buildings right now. Four of the gateways and one of the robotics, as well as the robotics bay. So if that gets taken down, he's going to be in the world of trouble. It's going to be very hard for him to reproduce his attack units.
It looks like he is doing the Baneling drop you're talking about. I see a ton of Banelings morphing at the expansion.
But oh my goodness, we do have Gravitic boosters coming down, which is the observer speed movement, which we almost never see. But I guess he did spot that Baneling drop, so he's trying to keep up with the overlords. Here they come. We have three overlords moving out, and another four overlords with units in them.
Oh man, that observer was right over it. I wonder if the Zerg even realizes that there's no possible way that this can end well for the Zerg.
Yeah, he's gonna have to be careful. Wants to go in first with the empty overlords, but it looks like he's not going to. He's gonna run into the entire army right now.
Oh boy.
My goodness, but still, the Baneling drops could do a lot of damage.
He didn't even drop all of his units. I think that was a poor control on his part. Typically, Banelings aren't the greatest against Stalkers, but if you can drop them directly onto a big Stalker ball like that, that could have been really well. I just don't think his Overlords drop how he wanted them to.
Yeah, very GG's. Wow. But yeah, Baneling drops are much more effective than I think than Banelings. I mean, when you have a Baneling running into the front of even a ball of units, you're only going to get half the splash damage, whereas if you drop them, you can get the full radius of splash, and that means a lot more units are going to be in the immediate splash vicinity, and you're also going to get the full secondary splash damage then as well. So even though Banelings don't do bonus damage versus Stalkers, if you do hit a Protoss ball with a few Baneling bombs, it is very beneficial. And cost-effective. And I'm not sure if that was the last game. I'm going to check here. But we did have Cookies taking that fourth game, so he did go 4-0 against the players of GMMA. Although, keep in mind that one of them was apparently just the manager. Did not actually look at his profile, but that would be interesting. And it looks like that was the last game, so best of seven versus SPS and GMMA. SPS taking it, so good job to them. Good job for Cookies for the all kill. Alright, so I guess I'll talk to you later. Thanks for helping me co-cast here. And I'm sure I'll hit you up for some better events. I know you only got to cast a couple games here, but...
Yeah. Oh, wait, are we off stream or whatever? Or are you still streaming?
I'm still streaming right now, but I'm probably going to turn my stream off. Because I don't think there's anything more to cast for tonight.
Okay.
And I've got some stuff to take care of, so... But in the near future, I hope we can do some more casting.
Yeah. Maybe some better games.
Yeah, hopefully. Hopefully better than the all-in Zergling on Lost Temple. Anyway, see you around.
Okay, have fun. See you later, broski.
Peace.
That was depressing. Oh my goodness. They're watching your stream? Who's they? How do you know they're watching my stream? Oh, this guy's actually fairly high. What the fuck? Holy shit, my brain, I can't reconcile what I just saw. Yeah, is GMMA like a magic fucking point booster? Holy shit. Oh my god, my brain is, it hurts. What the fuck? Dude, I'm gonna change my name to Destiny GMMA. I'm gonna be like 4,500 rating. Oh my goodness. I'm sorry, I'm not... I guess the guy didn't play a terrible game. Oh my goodness. Never mind. Okay. I don't understand, but okay. Multiboxing, do you even play StarCraft 2?
Oh, I didn't know that.
Guys, I'm StarCraft 2'd out for today. I might need to sleep. It's like 12:30, bros. Like classic games. The fuck is this? What is multitask? Holy fucking music. What do you do? Keep the ball balanced on the platform. Use the right and left arrow keys to tilt. Oops. Am I winning? Oh boy. This shit's about to get crazy. It's about to get crazy. Oh shit! Oh boy. Whoosh. Oh boy. It's like macroing, right? This is just a test of macro. Oh fuck. Touch the squares before any of them disappear and move around with the WASD keys. Touch the squares before any of them disappear. Oh shit. Ball, come back. Come back to the center. There you go. No, go back. I feel like I'm in the Matrix. Whoa. Avoid all oncoming obstacles. Hold the spacebar to move upwards and release it to fall. Holy shit. No, wait, fuck. I didn't mean to do that. I saw the other one and freaked out. Alright, let's try this again. Hold on. Aw, this shit's... I can't do this too many times in a row. This is gonna test my patience. Hey, I think I won. Holy shit. That's supposed to happen? Oh no, it's moving. Whoa, hey Red Ball. Don't get crazy. Shit, Red Ball, chill the fuck out. This is gonna get really hard when I have to do shit down there. Ah! I fucked up. It's too much for me. What's this? All right, bros. All right, I'm going off. I'm done StarCrafting. I'm just gonna fucking work on my website. Turn it off. If anybody wants to see any more StarCraft games, it's not happening. It's not happening. Not tonight. I'll play more tomorrow, though, I promise. Well, I don't promise. I mean, some crazy shit could happen, but... What? Oh, God damn it, speed. I knew what I was gonna do today. I'm going through all my emails. Make a big fucking FAQ stick up on my fucking website so people don't ask me the same fucking questions. Oh, I get it. Artosis with a nice surround.
Okay.
There's no fuck. That's the. It could have at least been a flat screen. You have any idea how hard you have to fucking punch that? No, I'm sorry. Now I'm being the fag. That's always like, it's not real. No, but really, that's really stupid. It's just not even close. Like, at least make it plausible. Oh yeah, and math too. I need to do that. Hey, what's up with this? How do you do it? Look, it's a fucking secret. You hold the left arrow and then push down. Hold on, wait, watch. Look, you play that fucking snake game. It's old? How fucking old is it? Why didn't I ever know about this shit? Look, there it is. Holy shit. I can't eat the dot. Oh my god. What the fuck? What? Fuck this game. Watching this again.
Oh yeah. Let me log in on this one.
Come on, you little bitches, let's go. That's right. Oh snap. Oh, not now. Oh, you just so suck. Oh on. Fuck. Hello?
What do you just get out of sales or something?
Nothing, I'm working. What's going on?
Hey, you here in Building 3?
Yeah, I'm in Building 3.
Well, why do I have to call an outside number to get to your desk?
Well, look, I don't want to get in an IP telephony conversation with you right now.
UP telephony? IP urine.
Why does this video always suck when it comes to loading?
That's
good.
We totally fell for it.
That's a good one.
All right, so what, dude, we got a problem. The website's down.
I'm sorry, what?
The website is down. What's black hole.
Fuck you, YouTube.
I can't get anything.
Fuck.
The website.
Okay, we're gonna pause for a second.
I'm sorry, what?
The website is down. What's black hole? I can't get anything.
Fuck!
Yeah.
Hold on. Well, it looks like it's up to me.
Well, I rebooted my PC and it's still that way.
How many times did you reboot?
Three, man. You always tell me to do three.
Well, hold on. It's up. I mean, I can check to see if Apache's running. Apache is running. Oops.
I don't know what this Apache is, but either way, I'm still not able to get
tell me to the port, you can get HTML, like it's running.
Okay, well, I'm still not able to get what I'm looking for. Nancy said that you guys rebooted last time. I don't know. I mean,
do you want me to reboot the web server, even though it's
I'm just
running.
Saying that that's what Nancy said you guys did last time, okay?
Well, I can reboot it now. It doesn't make any sense to reboot something that's
okay,
running.
Okay, well, I'm just telling you what Nancy said, that you guys rebooted last time. I'm not saying anything about you guys. I don't know.
Sure, why not? Let's reboot it. I mean, it's not fun to reboot a web server. I mean, that'll take 15 minutes, so, I can get back to the
server. Something just happened. I can't get to the homepage.
What do you mean you can't get to the homepage?
I just tried to get to the homepage, and I can't get
You could get to the homepage before?
Yeah, I was getting to the homepage, and now I can't get to the homepage.
You told me that the website was down. Fuck. So the website wasn't down.
Well, maybe that's not what I meant, okay?
The website's down now.
Whatever it's called, the World Wide Web.
The internet?
It's slow, everything is just slow.
You don't know the difference between the internet and our website?
Nancy, is your web working?
I told you it worked.
No, I know. He rebooted the website.
What?
He rebooted
Hold
it.
On. Hello?
Yeah, this is Trevor. I work for the City of Arvada, population 10,000. And I was just looking at our website, www.arvada.org/arvadaharvest. And I get this error message, page cannot be displayed.
Well, it's because the website's down.
Huh?
Oh, my God. Look, the sales guys upstairs took down the website, so we're waiting for it to come back.
And then I tried...
I guess it was Trevor.
I tried Arvada Harvest Festival /pumpkin patch, and that wasn't on there. And I tried Harvest Festival /beanbag race, and nothing's coming up. And I literally... have the mayor breathing down my neck right now, so we need to get this back up.
It should be up by now, honestly.
They call it online. We gotta get this page online.
Alright, Trevor. Well, can I call you back when it's up?
You know what? Call me back at this number. Literally have the mayor breathing down my neck. ArvadaPumpkinPatch.org.
Okay. Sure.
Huh?
Alright, I'll see you later. Okay.
Down because he rebooted it. I don't know. Why do you... say that again?
Listen. What was your name again? Chip?
Chip.
Can you...
I didn't have to.
Hold on a second. Hello?
Did you take down the website?
No.
Well, Nancy said you did.
Oh, I mean, yeah.
Why the hell did you do that?
Well, the sales guys...
Didn't you get my email about not taking down the web server?
No.
Well, I sent it to you.
Well... Hold on. Because I don't see it.
Well.
This is weird. I don't see it here. Okay, well, maybe I didn't send it to you.
Yeah, because seriously, you know, I didn't get it.
Well, the email said don't take it down because it won't come back up without being powered off.
Oh, crap.
Yeah. Thanks a lot.
I'm sorry. Fuck me. Look. Chip?
Yeah?
Look. Okay, the whisper's not coming up now because you made me take it down in the wrong way.
Okay.
I'm gonna have to get Laszlo to power it off. Can you hold on a minute?
Alright.
Fucking Laszlo, come on.
Hello, Derek, you fucking idiot. What rack is this in?
I'm sorry, what?
What rack is the system in?
It's in rack 5. Yes.
Rack
5? Rack 5.
Yeah, told me that you took down the system.
Yes. It was an accident.
What did he tell me?
Just reboot it.
You need the system rebooted?
Yes.
Which one is it?
It's gray. It's on the... It's like third down.
They're all gray.
I know. It's third down. You can see the gray on the bottom.
You need which... From the top or the bottom?
From the top.
You tell me.
It's... Jesus.
You tell me.
It's gray...
I can't hear anything.
I know. Shut up. It's gray on the bottom.
From the bottom.
It's gray on the bottom. It's not on the bottom of the rack.
From the top?
Yes. You just powered off the exchange, sir.
I'll be the top one now.
Fucking God.
Okay. Yeah, I did both of them, so you should be good.
Oh.
Alright, later.
Thanks a lot.
Down there.
Chip.
Hey.
Well, you managed to take the email system down as well.
Really? The email server?
Well, it doesn't have anything to do with the web server.
You just shut off all our email. okay.
Laszlo at the data center rebooted it when he was trying to fix the web server that you asked me to take down, so...
How many times?
How many times what?
How many times did he reboot it?
Once.
Well, I think you need to try a few more times.
Look at...
Well, dude, we're having a quarterly sales call in 2 minutes. I need to get on the website, or the internet, or whatever. That's why I called you in the first place. Help a brother out.
What's your asset tag, Chip?
The asset tag is 287-JPC and the number 2.
Is that P as in Paul?
That's P as in Paul.
Okay. Where'd you get this... Is this your desktop? Is the mouse...
Oh, my mouse is moved!
Okay. Yeah,
do that again. Oh my god, you're moving my mouse.
It's remote desktop. What is your password?
It's just the letter A.
Just the letter A, alright.
Like Apple. Are you looking at my desktop right now?
Dude, how many programs do you have running? You're totally overloading your box. That's probably part of the reason.
Well, I use all these programs. You know, I got a lot of work to do during the day. Whoa, hey, no. You can
do
that now. No, I need to save this.
Chip.
This is all my work.
Look. You don't need this stuff.
I've got some research that I'm doing, okay?
You don't... I mean, all these things take a
while. You can't close all my windows, okay?
Closing that.
Love you. You gotta slow down.
AOL? Don't use AOL. It's dial-up networking.
Well, how am I gonna get through the internet without AOL?
It's broadband.
But I got like 4,000 hours for free.
We have a corporate OC3. It costs like $1,000 a month, so don't use AOL. Whoa.
Can you carry over my hours?
What is this? Fuck you.
My desktop?
What? They're icons. They spell fuck you, and there's a picture of a penis.
Patricia did that when I took over her computer. She wasn't very happy.
Holy crap. How long has it been like that?
8 or 9 years.
Oh my god.
You know, I just got so used to it, I didn't want to change it.
That's fucking awesome. Hold on. Alright, I'm taking a picture of this. Hold on just a second.
Okay, so, seriously though, I've got like a meeting in 5 minutes, so whatever we gotta do to get my PC back.
No problem. This is going right onto Boing Boing.
What's Boing Boing?
Here's the thing. This is a problem. You can't have people looking at this, okay? Arrange your icons by name.
Whoa, no, I can't find anything!
What do you mean? It's alphabetical.
Oh, man, I had everything exactly where I knew where it was. I knew that our website was at the very tip of the penis. And now, I don't know where anything is. How many, you know, it's not that one. It's not that one anymore.
Well,
My Salesforce.com was on the right testicle. I'm not going to be able to find anything. I got a meeting in 2 minutes, and I need the icons back the way they were.
Well, I can't go back. There's no way to go back. You can't arrange my penis.
Oh, my gosh. I tell you, every time I've called you text four people, every fucking time, you guys do something entirely different, you know? You don't fix the problem that I call about. You know, all I wanted was to get the website back. That's all I needed. Can you restore it? You said you took a picture of it. Restore it.
Well, Yeah, I guess. I mean, I could just make that the background for your desktop.
I don't care what you have to do. Whatever you gotta do to get this thing back.
Honestly, that probably won't solve the problem completely, but...
Well, the icon's in the same spot. I'll be able to get to them. Alright, so this is worse. Oh, wait.
That's just a picture on the desktop.
This is perfect. This is perfect. Hey, I gotta get into my meeting, so... You know, this is great.
You good with it? Because...
No, this is fine. I can find everything. This is fine.
Okay.
Alright, so I gotta go to the meeting. Thanks a lot, Wes, dude. I'm out of here.
Okay.
Alright, bye.
Jesus, what a fucking day.
Blue team, score.
Yo! Yo, I told you not to take the website down! I told you not to take the website down! But you had to get all intern up in this, and you did it. Yo, someone give me a blueberry snapple! I said blueberry snapple! I can't feel my face!
Getting through the gatekeeper, I see salespeople try to manipulate or avoid that gatekeeper at all costs. Think about the picture the word gatekeeper conjures up for you. This big ogre at the other end of the line preventing you from speaking to the decision maker. Well, what if we change the phrase gatekeeper and call that person the concierge? What comes to mind when you think about a concierge?
Where's Chicago? Did I say baseball? I meant basketball. I got my balls screwed up.
That is Africa.
Nice pussy. The white sounds so
tough.
Niklas?
Hey, Niklas. Vad har du för svart mig?
Tull.
What?
Tull.
Vad har du?
Niklas?
Hey, Niklas. Vad har du för svart mig?
Tull.
Oh boy.
A sad day for Michigan players and fans who hope the team finds that inspiration in the death of a college football icon.
Ohio State!
Into the early morning hours, these showers are starting to die down a bit, and we are beginning to see some showers moving into Louisiana right now. Southeast satellite radar composite.
Satisfying end to this man house tonight. I can't hear shit. We apologize for the difficulties there.
I know it's dinner time, but let's talk
somebody got fired.
It's not just the thin man's getting thinner. All Girl Scout cookies will now be trans fat free. Cookie makers is... Ow! Honey.
Sorry.
Oh my god. I don't know that I...
Country a much better day than it's been today. Cloud will increase from the west.
J-Lo's new song, Jenny from the Block, all about Lopez roots. About how she's still a neighborhood gal at heart. But folks from that street in New York, the Bronx section, sound more likely to give her a curb job than a blow job or block party.
An infestation of Canadian brown finches, which is a small bird. I guess I should have seen that one coming, huh?
Well, the future of skateboarding is in Pioneer Courthouse Square as we speak.
News Channel 8's Cheryl Stewart is live with him right now. We're seeing the sweet moves that he's working up for the Do Action Sports Tour's upcoming Portland stop. Cheryl?
Hey, I've actually been practicing my ollie. You guys want to see? I've been practicing hard. Okay. Oh no.
One of the British designers' shows had the difficulty.
Oh, I got it.
Model...
I have to watch it again.
Do Action Sports Tour's upcoming Portland stop. Cheryl?
Hey, I've actually been practicing my ollie. You guys want to see? I've been practicing hard. Okay. Oh no.
One of the British designers' shows had the difficulty. A model fell down twice. That's her going down once. The young woman wearing that pink skirt and the orange platform shoes never quite recovered after that. There she goes. That had to hurt. That was uncool. That's embarrassing. This is at least the second time.
Well, you all are just really tickled by that, aren't you? You try walking in those shoes. Hey,
come on.
We want to apologize.
Hold on, hold on.
You want me to
As you can see behind me.
Oh my god.
Alright, so I've got my trusty stopwatch, and here they come down the hill. It looks like Ruben is in the lead, and here comes Alan.
Oh shit!
That was a bad idea.
What really happened on that Thursday here in Augusta?
In the lead and
fucked up.
Alright, so I've got my trusty stopwatch, and here they come down the hill. It looks like Ruben is in the lead, and here comes Alan. That was a bad idea.
What really happened on that Thursday here at Augusta High School that led to Chris Wood's death?
What the fuck is that? Shit! I'm dying in this fucking country-ass fucked-up town.
Wow.
Shit flying in my mouth. Oh, fuck. I can't see pilot. Just get the fuck out of this country, motherfucker.
What the fuck?
Jet stream, the upper level pattern dividing the cold and warm air asses of warm air masses. There's one for the tape right there.
Good luck. Thank you, Christoph. You're the host. I am kidding. Here you go.
You know, the first time anybody's ever slapped that buzzer and didn't use their hands. I need an answer. I probably need two.
5 seconds, here we go. 290 pounds. What do you think it is? Is it the lights on? So, here comes the bonus.
Here, guy, what's going on?
That woman always ends up on her knees somewhere. What is she? She falls over.
Name something people take from hotels as a souvenir.
Anne. The lamps.
Talking, is it, Anne?
If you'll do strange things to my dog, his name is Tim.
To move from a tiny general hospital, don't worry, we haven't paid the lighting bill.
Any good boat enthusiast should know that when a man falls out of your boat and into the water, you should yell, "Man overboard!" Now, what should you yell if a woman falls overboard?
Full speed ahead.
It's Nick Ware. Yeah!
Oh no, not the stairs.
400.
G for George.
One. And that sound means you have to solve.
Tom Hanks, the green mole.
Horacio de la Peña, que juega una final hoy en los Estados Unidos, el tenis internacional con Sampras, que le ganó a Jean Courier, el tenis...
Bank, you're the champions. Name something men wear to bed, Margaret.
A nightcap.
A nightcap, Jeff.
Sweatsuit.
Sweatsuit, AW. Yeah.
Nightcap.
Nightcap, Elizabeth.
Condoms.
A condom!
Love when the room begins to shake. It's an earthquake. Oh. But only about 3.2 on the Richter scale. Do you think you'd stop, or would you continue?
I sure as heck ain't gonna stop. We need all the help we can get.
Halbliterflasche, Hauptbahnhof, Hochbaufenster oder Hornbrillen?
Of this document, well, here's a little flavor of what's in it. This bill contains the proposed changes in the Constitution. Sounds funny.
Ask number one. If I told you that I was really ugly, but I had strong bones and healthy teeth, would you still want to take me out?
Well, sure. I have a nice farm. I think I could use you one.
Wow.
Country has supplied the most objects in your house or apartment? Mary?
Africa, because
Africa.
We have this picture of this, I don't know how to explain it, but it's just a picture and it's a dark face on it.
Okay.
And,
let's see if your husband said that. He said Sweden.
Sweden. Who's going to bring that $2 picture from Africa over here?
The picture she's talking about, Tijuana.
Alright, bros, I need to get to work.
Less than a minute now.
Tool time for 200.
This term for a long-handled gardening tool can also mean an immoral pleasure seeker. Ken.
What's a hoe?
No. Whoa! Whoa! Whoa. They teach you that in school in Utah, huh? Al.
What's a rake?
A rake is right. You select, Al.
400, please.
Speed, I'm about to do it right now, bro. Okay, bros. I'm working hard. Be careful. Later.